the pair of linear equation to variables, we are going to discuss the exercise 3.6. So starting with the very first question, as you can see on the screen, so the very first equation is 1 over 2x plus 1 over 3y is equal to 2, and the second equation is 1 over 3x plus 1 over 2y is equal to 13 upon 6. So how to solve this equation? So let we are taking 1 over x is equal to a and 1 over y is equal to b. So the equation will become a upon 2 plus b upon 3 is equal to 2. And this will become 3a plus 2b is equal to 12. Then we can write this equation, that is second equation, as a upon 3 plus b upon 2 is equal to 13 upon 6, which will become 2a plus 3b is equal to 13. So now we can either use the elimination method, okay, and or by using the substitution method. So we are using substitution method here. So continuing this equation, we can write this a is equal to 12 minus 2b whole over 3. Now what to do? Now we'll put this value in the equation number 4. Okay, so putting the value of a from equation 4, we get this. So that is twice of 12 minus 2b over 3 plus 3b is equal to 13. So which will give us b is equal to 3. Now putting this b is equal to 3 in equation number 4, which will give us a is equal to 12 minus 2 into 3 whole over 3 is equal to 2. That will give a is equal to 2. Now this is not the complete answer because we have to find the value of x and y. So we have taken 1 over x is equal to a or a is equal. So we have here 1 over x is equal to 2. It means x is equal to 1 upon 2 and 1 upon y is equal to b, which means 1 upon y is equal to 3. That means y is equal to 1 upon 3. So we have the values x is equal to half and y is equal to half. Now moving towards the second part. In the second part, the equation is given 2 over root x plus 3 over root y is equal to 2 and 4 over root x minus 9 over root y is equal to minus 1. So how to solve? What we are doing here, we are again taking, let 1 over root x is equal to a, 1 over root y is equal to b. Now from the equation 1 we get this here, that is 2a plus 3b is equal to 2. So we can write a is equal to 2 minus 3b upon 2 because we are going to use the substitution method. Then equation 2 we get here 4a minus 9b is equal to minus 1. Now putting this value from the equation 4, so 4 times of 2 minus 3b all over 2 minus 9b is equal to minus 1. So we get here b is equal to 1 upon 3. Now putting the value of b in the equation number 4, that is a is equal to 2 minus 3 into 1 upon 3 whole upon 2, that is 1 upon 2. So from the equation 3 we get 1 over root x is equal to 1 upon 2 and 1 upon root y is equal to 1 upon 3. So squaring on both sides, so we'll get 1 upon x is equal to 1 upon 4 and 1 upon y is equal to 1 upon 9. So the result will be x is equal to 4 and y is equal to 9. Then moving towards the third part. So in the third part, we can see it is given 4 upon x plus 3y is equal to 14 and 3 over x minus 4y is equal to 23. So let 1 upon x is equal to a. Let 1 upon x is equal to a. So from the equation 1 we get 4a plus 3y is equal to 14, which means a is equal to 14 minus 3y whole upon 4, because again we are using the substitution method. So we can also use the elimination method here. Then from the equation 2 we get 3a minus 4y is equal to 23. Now putting the value from equation 4 in place of a, so we will get a thrice of 14 minus 3y all upon 4 minus 4y is equal to 23, which gives us on solving y is equal to minus 2. Then putting this value in the equation 4, we get a is equal to 14 minus 3 into minus 2 all upon 4, that will be 5. So now this is the value of a and b. Now we have to find the value of x and y. So in order to find the value of x and y, so right here 1 over x is equal to 5 and 1 of, that means x is equal to 1 upon 5. Okay, and y value we have already found. So the value of x is 1 upon 5 and the value of y is minus 2. Then moving towards the next part, in the fourth part, if we see here, it is given that 5 over x minus 1 plus 1 over y minus 2 is equal to 2 and 6 over x minus 1 minus 3 over y minus 2 is equal to 1. So let 1 over x minus 1 is equal to a and 1 over y minus 2 is equal to b. So from the equation 1 we get, what we are getting, 5a plus b is equal to 2, then b is equal to 2 minus 5a. We are using the substitution method, so we have taken the value of a in terms of b, or the value of b in terms of a we have taken here. So from the equation 2 we get 6a minus 3b is equal to 1. So putting the value of b from the equation 4, we get 6a minus thrice of, in place of b we are adding 2 minus 5 is equal to 1. So we have 6a minus 6 plus 15 is equal to 1. So 21a is equal to 7, a is equal to 1 upon 3. Now a is equal to 1 upon 3. Now putting the value of a is equal to 1 upon 3 in the equation 4, we are getting b is equal to 2 minus 5 into 1 upon 3, which is equal to 1 upon 3. Now putting these value where we have taken like 1 over 1, x minus 1 is equal to a, 1 over y minus 2 is equal to b. So we are getting here x minus 1 is equal to 3 and y minus 2 is equal to 3. Now we can easily solve here. We are getting x equals to 4 and y equals to 5. So x equals to 4, y equals to 5 is our required answer. These are the values of x and y. Now moving towards the fifth part. So in the fifth part, it is given that 7x minus 2y whole upon xy is equal to 5. That means 7x over xy minus 2y over xy is equal to 5. That means 7 over y minus 2 over x is equal to 5. Then second is 8x plus 7y whole over xy is equal to 15. So we can write here 8x over xy plus 7y over xy is equal to 15. So we can write here 8 over y plus 7 over x is equal to 15. Okay, so we can use the other methods also. So let 1 over x is equal to a and 1 over y is equal to b. So the equation reduced to 7b minus 2a is equal to 5. And that means 7b is equal to 5 plus 2a or b is equal to 5 plus 2a whole upon 7. Now putting this value in the equation, 8b plus 7 is equal to 15. So we get 8 into b. Value of b is 5 plus 2a whole upon 7 plus 7 is equal to 15. On solving this, we are getting a is equal to 1. Now putting the value of a in the equation 4, we get b is equal to 5 plus 2 into 1 whole over 7, that is 1. So we are getting the value of a is equal to 1, b is equal to 1. Now we have to find the value of x. So 1 upon x is equal to, we have taken as a here, as a. So 1 over x is equal to 1, which means x is equal to 1. Then 1 over y is equal to b. So we have taken 1 over y is equal to b. Value of b is 1. So y is equal to 1. It means the value of x is equal to 1 and the value of y is equal to 1. Now if we move towards the next part, so in the next part we can see here, yes, in the sixth part it is given to us 6x plus 3y is equal to 6y. So this can be written as dividing the whole by xy. So we are getting here 6 over xy plus 5 3y over xy is equal to 6. That means 6 over y plus 3 over x is equal to 6. Then 2x plus 4y is equal to 5xy. So we can write here in the same way cross multiply. So we are getting 2x plus 4y whole over xy is equal to 5. 2x over xy plus 4y over xy is equal to 5. Then we are getting 2 upon y plus 4 upon x is equal to 5. Now let 1 upon x is equal to a, 1 upon y is equal to b. So from the equation 1, we get 6a plus 3b is equal to 6. It means 6b is equal to 6 minus 3a. That means b is equal to 6 minus 3a upon 6. Now putting this value in the next equation. And we have 2b plus 4a is equal to 5. So putting this value twice of 6 minus 3 whole upon 6 plus 4 is equal to 5. That means 12 minus 6a plus 24a is equal to 30. So that means a is equal to 1. So a is equal to 1. Now finding the value of b, putting this in the equation number 4, the value of b is coming here 6 minus 3 into 1 whole over 6, that is 1 upon 2. Now from the equation 3, we get 1 upon x is equal to 1, because 1 over x is 1 upon x is equal to a we have taken, and the value of a is equal to 1, so value of x will be 1. Then 1 upon y is equal to b, that means 1 upon y is equal to 1 upon 2, that means y is equal to 2. So we have x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1. Then moving towards the next part, that is 7th part. So in the 7th part, we can see here that it is given 10 over x plus y plus 2 over x minus y is equal to 4. Then 15 over x plus y minus 5 over x minus y is equal to minus 2. Now we are taking let 1 over x plus y is equal to a, 1 over x minus y is equal to b. Now from the equation first, we are getting 10a plus 2b is equal to 4. It means 2b is equal to 4 minus 10a, or b is equal to 4 minus 10a whole upon 2. Then from equation 2, we are getting 15 minus 5b is equal to minus 2. So to putting the value of this b from the equation 4, so we are getting 15a minus 5 into 4 minus 10a whole upon 2 is equal to minus 2. On solving this, we are getting a is equal to 1 upon 5. So putting the value of a in the equation number 4, we'll get here b is equal to 4 minus 10 into 1 upon 5 whole upon 2, which is equal to 1. Now, so we know the value of b, we know the value of, now after knowing these values, what we will do, we'll just put these values. So we are getting here 1 over x plus y is equal to 1 upon 5, that is x plus y is equal to 5. 1 over x minus 1 is equal to 1, that means x minus 1 is y is equal to 1. Now from these, if we add both the equations, so 2x is equal to 6, x is equal to 3. Now putting this value in any of the equation, and then we will get y is equal to 2. So these are the values of x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 2. Okay, now so now in the 8th part, if you see here, it is given that 1 over 3x plus y plus 1 over 3x minus y is equal to 3 upon 4. And second equation is 1 over twice of 3x plus y minus 1 over twice of 3x minus y is equals to minus 1 over 8. Now, so let 1 over 3x plus y is equals to a and 1 over 3x minus y is equals to b. So, from the equation 1, we get a plus b is equals to 3 upon 4, which means b is equals to 3 minus 4a whole upon 4. Now, from the equation 2, we get a upon 2 minus b upon 2 is equals to minus 1 upon 8. Putting the values of b from the equation 4, we get a upon 2 minus half of 3 minus 4a whole upon 4 is equals to 1 minus 1 upon 8. So that means we are getting a is equals to 1 upon 4. Now putting this value of a in equation number 4, we get b is equals to 3 minus 4 into 1 upon 4 whole upon 4, which means 2 upon 4, which means 1 upon 2. So this is what we are getting the value of a and b. Now we have to find the value of x and y. So if you look here, so now it is, we know that we have taken 1 over 3x plus y is equal to a, that is 1 upon 4. So this will become 3x plus y is equal to 4. Then 1 upon 3x minus y is equal to 1 upon 2, that is b. So this is 3x minus y is equal to 2. Now add equation 5 and 6, we are getting 6x is equal to 6, that is x is equal to 1. From the equation 5, we get 3 plus y is equal to 4, which gives us y is equal to 1. So hence the values are x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1. Now, if you move towards the question number 2, in the question number 2, they are saying, formulate the following problems as a pair of the equation, hence find their solutions. So, starting with the very first part, so as we can see here, the Ritu can row the downstream 20 km in 2 hours and the upstream 4 km in 2 hours. So, find the speed of the rowing in the still water and the speed of the current. So, looking at, so let the speed of the rowing in still water is x km per hour. So, let the speed of the water is y km per hour. So, towards the downstream, the speed will be increased. That is x plus y kilometer per hour. So, and the distance 20 kilometer, time is 2 hours. So, we have, according to the equation, speed is equal to distance upon time. That means x plus y is equal to 20 upon 2, which means x plus y is equal to 10, and y is equal to 10 minus x and be written here. Now, towards the upstream, the speed will be x minus y kilometer per hour. Distance is 4 kilometer, time is 2 hours. So, speed is equal to distance upon time. So, that is x minus y is equal to 4 upon 2, which gives x minus y is equal to 2. Putting the values of y from equation 1, we get 10 x minus 10 minus x is equal to 2, that means x is equal to 6. Now putting this value of x in equation 1, we get y is equal to 4. So 4 is the answer of this. So it means the speed of rowing in the still water is 6 km per hour and the speed of water is 4 km per hour. Now if you look at the second part is, a two women and five men can together finish an embroidery work in 4 days, while three women and six men can finish in 3 days. So find that the time taken by one woman alone and to finish the work, and also the time taken by one man alone. So looking here, so let the number of days taken by one woman to complete the work is x days, and the number of days taken by one man to complete the work is y days. So the work done by one woman in 1 day is 1 upon x, and the work done by one man in 1 day is 1 upon y. So according to the first condition we have here, 4 times of twice upon x plus 5 upon y is equal to 1, and that is 8 upon x plus 20 upon y is equal to 1, because we are finding the 1 day's work. Then according to second condition, thrice of 3 upon x plus 6 upon y is equal to 1, so that is 9 upon x plus 18 upon y is equal to 1. Now we are taking 1 upon x is equal to a and 1 upon y is equal to b. So now the equation will become 8a plus 20b is equal to 1, that is a is equal to 1 minus 20b whole upon 8. Then we have 9a plus 18b is equal to 1, which means, now putting the value from equation 4, so 9 times of 1 minus 20b over 8 is plus 18b is equal to 1. So that is 9 minus 180b plus 144b is equal to 8. That will give us b is equal to 1 upon 36. Now putting this in the value in the question number 4, so we get a is equal to 1 minus 20 into 1 upon 36 whole upon 8. So we have 4 upon 32, that means 1 upon 18. So from the equation 3, we get 1 over x is equal to 1 upon 18 and 1 upon y is equal to 1 upon 13. That will give us x is equal to 18 and y is equal to 36. So it means the woman will take 18 days and the one man will take 36 days to complete the work. Now then if you see the third part, so in the third part the question is, yes, Rahul travels 300 km to her home, Ruhi travels 300 km to her home partially by the train and partially by the bus. She takes 4 hours if she travels 16 km by train and remaining by bus. If she takes 100 km by train and remaining by the bus, she takes 10 minutes longer. So find the speed of the train and the bus separately. So we have to find the speed of both. So let us see here. Let the speed of train be x kilometer per hour, speed of the bus be y kilometer per hour. So she, if she travels 60 km by the train and remaining by the bus, she take 4 hours. So according to the question, we have 60 upon x plus 240 upon y is equal to 4. If she travels 100 km by train and the remaining, that is 200 km by the bus, she will take 10 minutes more. So 10 minutes more. It means, so we have here, so 10 minutes more, so according to the question we can write 10 over x plus 200 over y is equal to 4 plus 10 upon 60. So we'll get here 10 over x plus 200 over y is equal to 25 upon 6. This is question number 2. So let 1 over x is equal to a, 1 upon y is equal to b. So from v, then we can write 60a plus 240b is equal to 4, that is a is equal to 4 minus 240 over b over 60. So we can use the elimination method also, whichever you find easy you can use the method. So from the equation 2, we are getting 100a plus 200b is equal to 25 upon 6. Now putting this value of a from equation 4, we are getting 100 into 4 minus 240b over 60 plus 200b is equal to 25 over 6. On solving this, we are getting b is equal to 1 over 80. Now putting this value in the equation number 4, a is equal to 4 minus 240 into 1 over 80 whole upon 60, that is equal to 1 upon 60. So from the equation 3, we get 1 over x is equal to 1 upon 60, 1 upon y is equal to 180. So result is x is equal to 60, y is equal to 80. So the speed of the train is 60 km per hour and the speed of the bus is 80 km per hour. So with this, we come to the end of this exercise. So